Every time I think I'm not an awards guy, I stand here and I'm holding this thing and I'm like, this is like 10-year-old Kunal in New Delhi in the shower holding his shampoo and dreaming of moments like this. So I'm just gonna talk for hours.
The Asian Awards in its sixth year celebrated in partnership with Global Citizen outstanding achievements of the Asian communities across the globe in music, television, sports and more.
We're celebrating tonight the cultural successes, the business successes, the media successes, the singers. And the great thing about London is you can achieve anything. And we're celebrating the world's diversity in the world's greatest city tonight.
I think as the Asian Awards grow, it's only going to add impact, you know, add value. People are going to see it, they're going to take notice. They're going to see that there are really important people, not only in the Asian community, but also in the British community.
Social media trends like Oscars So White and others relating to the BAFTAs, Grammys and Golden Globes have all highlighted a certain resentment from parts of the community. This in turn got me thinking, we started this ceremony to highlight the achievements of Asian people because our stories are just not being heard by the masses.
Asian people can be anything that they want, just like any other people. It should be the fact that race doesn't even matter and that it should just be colorblind casting. And we're getting there with black actors, but I think Asian is still, we're years behind them.
And I think that people always perceive that they know what you can do. Now, whether that's me as an actor, or Asians as a group, or British Asians, or you know any subgroup, there's a presumption of what their abilities are.
Well, I'm here to support my really great friend, Naughty Boy. He's up for an award tonight, so I was just really honored to be asked to come and present this to him.
I did say no to begin with. Not because for any other reason, but I didn't think I was ready. Because I feel like this mean like I should retire or something. But
I just wanted to be known for making good music first. I didn't want to be known as the brown guy or the Asian guy because I feel like that's like I didn't want to fly that flag until I had success. Then I've got reason to fly that flag. Then it's based on not me being Asian and successful, it's just me being a music guy. And
I think there are a few role models. I think there definitely could be more. I mean, I personally, my dream is to do television, commercial British television, like X Factor, like Strictly Come Dancing. So I think once you see Asians coming through doing that kind of thing, then we know that that's another ceiling shattered.
But I think it's a wonderful time we're living in. There's a lot more TV roles, there's a lot more writing roles, there's a lot more directors and producers and artists that are coming from these communities. And it's really wonderful to be one of those who gets to do it for a living.
To accept the award on behalf of the Blessed Mother Teresa, please welcome the closest living relative to Mother Teresa, Aggie Boishu.
I just want to say thank you very much for this award. And I'm happy that everybody is remembering Mother Teresa and her work.
It's so important to have an award ceremony like this, which shines the light on the huge contribution that the Asian community has made to Britain and globally.